Hello students, welcome. In today's class we are going to learn one play, one-act play. That is the title of the play is Trifles. This trifle one-act play was written by Susan Glasspell, who was born in 1876 and died in 1948. She was a famous American playwright, novelist, journalist and actress. This Trifles story shows that is the concept of male domination. It is about different aspect among the characters. So in today's class, being based on it, we are going to discuss about the main plot of this play, main characters, who perform what kind of role in the play. We will discuss about this. So now let's start the play Trifles by Susan Glasspell. In the play, there are various characters. That is George Anderson, one that is a country, that is one country attorney, and Henry Peters, sheriff, Mrs. Peter, wife of sheriff, Lewis L., a neighboring farmer of Wright, John Wright, and Mrs. L., wife of Lewis L., and John Wright and Mrs. Wright, neighbors to the Mrs. Hill. These are the central character. These are the character in this play Trifles by Susan Glasspell. So we will discuss about this Trifles in summarized from here. Trifle is a suspense and mysterious one-act play written by Susan Glasspell, an American playwright, novelist, journalist, and actress. This play shows various aspects related to women's lives and their self-priorities. It indicates the various themes related to women's lives as isolation, loss of identity, male domination, revenge and violence, feminism, freedom by rebellion, etc. We can see in the play, that is Trifles. The whole play is about an investigation related to the murder mystery of Mr. John Wright, who was murdered. So this play surrounds about the murder mystery of John Wright, who murdered to him. For his murder, his wife, Mrs. Minnie Wright, has been accused and arrested. This play has shown this particular murder's investigation as well as a different perspective of Mrs. Wright's behavior about her and different proofs related to this murder. In this play, the major topic of discussion is Mrs. Wright, who is off the stage. The entire tracks of the investigation moves on along with the hypothesis, proofs, and Mrs. Wright's discussion. So about this, here John Wright is invisible person. We cannot only the people who are under the investigation, they are having long discussion about the hypothesis, about the proofs. Who murdered Mr. John Wright, his wife or other, okay, there is a discussion about this. So according to the play, it begins in the farmhouse of Mr. John Wright. In the beginning, we find the characters entering into Mr. Wright's kitchen. Firstly, country attorney Mr. George Henderson, Mr. Henry Peters and Mr. Lewis Hale enter the kitchen. All these men are followed by Mrs. Peters and Mrs. L. The condition of the kitchen is completely messy there, very different. When they reach there, they find everything shabby and abandoned. They see in the kitchen, the dishes in the kitchen lay scattered. It's here, a loaf of bread is out of the bread box, a dish towel on the table, unwashed pans under the sink, etc. It seems as if it is a sign of incomplete work. All the main characters move near the fireplace, whereas the woman stands at the door. The country attorney, Mr. Anderson, inspects the things in the kitchen, confirming whether the things are touched or not. He confirms there. He starts his investigation. Mr. Anderson starts his investigation with a question to Mr. Hill about the previous day's event. Mr. L is a person who witnessed the dead body of Mr. Wright at first. Mr. L relates that he visited Mr. Wright's house to ask about getting a telephone line. He met Mr. Wright sitting on the rocker, a chair, moving back and forth. She seemed quite strange and nervous. While pleating her apron, she strangely behaved with Mr. Hell. She informed Mr. Hell about her husband's death, obviously with a rope around his neck. That is Mrs. Wright. She informed that. She said that someone strangled her husband when she was in her sound sleep. So both of them, they were sleeping in the same bed. She didn't know about this, how it happened. Mrs. Wright, she told that, someone killed Mr. Wright there. She said that someone strangled her husband when she was in her sound sleep. She added that she did not hear anything from her husband during the night time. After that, Mr. Hill informed about the death of Mr. John Wright to Mr. Andy Peters, brought him to the spot to see the dead body. He even went to bring the coroner and official related to the investigation of suspicious death. When Mr. Hill talked about the telephone to Mrs. Wright, she laughed and even scared. So when he informed about this, the county attorney, Mr. George Anderson, begins his investigation from the kitchen. He inspects some fruits, preservatives, broken glass jars in the cupboards closest. The broken jars, glasses have made the cupboard so messy. Both Mr. Henderson and Mr. Peter criticize the trifles what is related to preservatives jars of the Mrs. Wright, who has been accused and arrested for her husband murder. Actually, Mrs. Wright was accused of her husband mother murder there, that is Mr. Wright. Mr. Anderson keeps on criticizing Mrs. Wright's housekeeping skills and dirty towels. They dominate the woman here. But Mr. Hale and Mrs. Peter support Mrs. Wright being woman. Both women don't like Mr. Hale's dialogue. Mr. Hale says that women worry over the trifles. Both women come to closer to each other after hearing this dialogue. The men move upstairs to search for evidence when in the house of John Wright. Mr. Anderson allows both women to gather the belongings for Mrs. Wright. Mr. Anderson, handed a task to Mrs. Hill, to observe the belongings of Mrs. Wright there. So when Mrs. Hill arranges pan in the kitchen, Mr. Anderson disturbs her. Mr. Anderson disturbs her there. We get to know. So Mrs. Hell does not like Mr. Anderson talks of criticizing women. We discussed that. Both women take clothes for Mrs. Wright from her closet. Later on, both women start talking about Mrs. Wright. Mrs. Hell relates. We get to know about this. So here both Mrs. Hill and another woman, they observe the clothes belonging to Mrs. Wright there. Both women they take clothes for Mrs. Wright from her closet. Later on, both women start talking about Mrs. Wright. Mrs. Hill relates about Mrs. Wright to Mrs. Peters. According to her, Mrs. Wright was a quite famous singer 30 years ago. She told this story Mrs. Wright was a quite famous singer 30 years ago and known as Minnie Foster. She was so beautiful and cheerful then. She used to wear a pretty dress and sing quite beautifully. But after her marriage, her happiness ended. Her husband was a quite strict person. She didn't allow her to join woman's aid. After marriage, she mostly wore an apron with a shawl, which was hung behind the door. Mrs. Hell considered Mrs. Wright as an innocent woman who worries about fruits, preservative jars. Both women don't think that Mrs. Wright murdered her husband. So according to Mrs. Peter, her husband doubts Mrs. Wright. He did not believe Mrs. Wright act of not waking up at night time during the murder. Mrs. Hell even mentioned that her husband found a gun in the house. It is very suspicious to use the rope for murder instead of gun. Mrs. Hill is worried about Mrs. Wright, who is locked in the town's prison. A bit later, Mrs. L finds a large sewing basket with a kilt. When they examine the kilt, they find the stitches in the kilt are not well stitched. They infer about Mrs. Wright's nervousness while stitching the quilt. When the men hear women's discussion related to quilt and knots, they laugh and ridiculous. The trifle strikes a woman. Then the woman, the men go to the barn to search for evidence. Both women want to complete the unfinished quilt while searching for paper and string in the house of Mr. John Wright. Mrs. Peter finds a bird cage in the cupboard. There is not a bird, and the door of the cage is broken there. Mrs. Hall remembers a man who was selling singing birds, canaries around the previous year. They infer Mr. Wright must have bought a canary for him. Mrs. Hall guesses that the cat might have caught the bird of the cage, but Mrs. Peter informs that Mrs. Hall that Mrs. Wright did not have a cat. She says that her cat once went into Mrs. Wright's room and made her upset. So this shows that Mrs. Wright, she did not like to keep a cat there. Mrs. Hale worries about not visiting Mrs. Wright's house 3 days. Mrs. Hale, she did not come to Mrs. Wright's house, since some days there. According to her, she never liked this lonesome and gloomy place, which is quite hollow and too far from the road. Mrs. L adds that Mr. Wright was quite a hard man to live with. There were no children in the house. There were many children of Mr. and Mrs. Wright there. Mrs. Wright had to spend all time in the loneliness with Mr. Wright was at his work. Mrs. L guessed that Mrs. Wright must have bought a canary for her company. She bought one canary, means bird here, one small bird. Mrs. L says that she was like a bird, real sweet and pretty, sing beautifully in a choir before marriage. She wonders how did she change there. Later on, Mrs. L find a pretty red box with sewing basket while searching for scissor to fix the stitch made by Mrs. Wright. Both of them are quite surprised to find a dead canary warp in the silk clothes. So when they found this box, inside the box there was a bird was dead inside it. They feel terrified to see to see the wrong neck of the bird. When they hear the sound of men coming back from the barn, they hide the red box among the kilt pieces. Mr. Anderson again ridicules the woman, asking about the blanket, whether it was knotted or kilt. Mrs. Peter answered decisively, saying that Mrs. Wright wanted to knot it. The men discuss finding no evidence in the barn. The men discuss about rope, which was the house rope and used for murdering Mr. Wright. They move upstairs again to make an analysis of the rope inch by inch. Now, both women get a new insight into Mrs. Wright's situation. So when they got this red box and they found the dead body of the bird there, so they came with new idea there. Mrs. Hall says that Mrs. Wright was trying to bury her lovely bird in a pretty red box. Mrs. Peters recalls an incident of her past days and becomes sad. According to her, she told one story there. She had a beautiful kitten when she was a girl, but a boy killed her kitten brutally with a hatch before her eyes. Quite interestingly, she says that if she had been bold enough, she would have hurt the boy, but she could not there. So she says that if he had been, yes, already, that is here, Mrs. Peter opines revealed the concept of revenge. Both women try to connect the case of killing a bird to the murder of Mr. Wright. They come into the point. Mr. Hell concludes that Mr. Wright was a strict man who didn't like his wife singing, and even singing birds like canary. After many years of emptiness in the house, the bird started singing. She is sure that Mr. Wright must have killed the bird, being furious. So Mrs. Peter relates her own experience of stillness, emptiness. She lost her first 2 years of old baby in the past. After the death of her baby, she passed her tough time without her baby. But she adds that the law has to punish the crime. Mrs. L also recalls Mrs. Wright while she was single. She feels guilty for not visiting and supporting Mrs. Wright in her needs during these days. Mrs. L became sympathetic towards Mrs. Wright and decided not to tell about broken jar of the preservatives to a male person there. Mrs. Peter Watts finds our preservative in a petticoat for Mrs. Wright dear. She captured dear. They don't want to make her sad. Mrs. Peter knows that the men would laugh at them being upset over the dead canary. The men came downstairs saying that they need definite evidence for the culprit. Mr. Anderson does not seem satisfied to proceed with the case further. He wishes to stay there for any other clue. Mrs. Peter asks Mr. Anderson to verify the willingness of Mrs. Wright, which she has taken. Mr. Anderson verifies them randomly, saying that she is also tied with a law being a sheriff's wife. The sheriffs and coroner move to the other room's window to look for evidence. Mr. Hale also goes out. Then both women conceal the evidence. They had the evidence read to Mrs. Wright. Mrs. Peter tried to hide the box in her bag. The box is too big. She tries to catch the canary but cannot touch it. Mrs. Hale snatches the box from Mrs. Peter and puts it into the big coat's pocket as she hears the door sound in the other room. This play ends up with a conversation between Mr. Anderson and Mrs. Hale. Mr. Anderson asks the ladies sarcastically about Mrs. Wright, saying that she was not going to kill it. But Mr. Hale defends Mrs. Wright, saying that she was going to not. So in this way, this play shows dominance of woman by the male character. So here the male character, different male character, their sound, their voices always in domination of the woman. So here two women, when they got some proof, when they got some evidence, they try to hide this and they try to save Mrs. Wright here. So there are some questions. Do you believe that Mrs. Wright killed her husband? So according to this shows that yes, I believe Mrs. Wright murdered her husband. After reading the entire play, I believe she is a murderer. Mrs. Hale and Mrs. Peter, through investigation into Mrs. Wright's minor transgression, reveal all of the evidence against her and prove her to be a murderer. So when Mr. John Wright, he killed the canary one bird, then canary was her company in the absence of Mr. John Wright. So the canary was sang very beautiful song. Yes, she also sang before 30 years, she used to a good singer there. Mrs. Wright. So later on, Mrs. Wright, it shows that while going through the play,